The CDC recently announced that the flu is widespread here in Connecticut. Influenza affects millions of Americans every year, leading to more than 200,000 hospitalizations nationwide. But there are some things you can do to keep the flu bug away. Here to help us figure all that out is Dr. Louise Dembry, an epidemiologist at Yale-New Haven Hospital. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming in so early. So I was saying to you before we came on the air that I think of the flu season or the time to fight the flu season in the fall, but you can still do a lot of things now?
There's still a lot you can do. I think you think of it as the fall because that's when we promote flu vaccination, but
yeah,
we tend to see more flu later in the winter months. February and March are the main peak months for flu in general,
okay,
but it's not too late at all to get vaccinated. We've been seeing more cases in Connecticut the last 3 weeks or so, so there's a fair amount
really?
Of flu activity.
Okay.
And if somebody hasn't gotten vaccinated yet, there's still plenty of vaccine. It's still a good time to get vaccinated. It's the best protection.
So you can get the flu shot now, but if
yes,
you do get the flu shot, that's not a 100% guarantee that you won't get the flu?
That's correct. The flu vaccine is not 100% protective. In younger people, those who are very healthy, it tends to be more protective than in people who are older, whose immune systems don't work as well. But it's still important that everybody get the flu vaccine. The CDC now recommends it for everybody,
okay,
not just certain high-risk groups.
That's interesting because I don't generally get the flu shot. I probably shouldn't tell you that. Just because I never fell into any of the categories,
right,
but now they say everyone. Why has that changed?
Well, because we know that it's important for everybody to be protected, because even if you were to get the flu and you might not get very sick or have complications, you could spread it to somebody else.
Okay.
So part of the prevention is to cut down on the amount of flu in the community so people who are high-risk for complications will be less likely to get flu, and
okay,
they don't respond as well to the vaccine, so they need for us to protect ourselves too.
Makes sense. So you are now seeing more cases of the flu. Is there a bad strain out there, or it's just your general flu?
What we're
season?
Seeing this year is mostly what's called influenza A, and there's two types of influenza A in the vaccine this year, H3N2 and the H1N1 that everybody will remember from 2 years ago,
mm-hmm,
the swine flu. These are the most common circulating strains right now. There's a little bit of flu B. All three of those are in the vaccine.
Okay. And tell me what the difference is between the cold and the flu with the symptoms as far, because I know there's a little bit, it's hard to tell sometimes which one you have.
It can be difficult to tell, but generally the flu comes on very suddenly, pretty abruptly. You tend to have more fever, chills with it, muscle aches, but you can have sore throat, not as much nasal congestion, but some people do get that. And in some people, particularly children with certain strains of flu, they may have more nausea and vomiting. But more the distinguishing feature is how quickly it comes on.
Okay. And it's the fever. You don't generally get a fever with a cold, or no?
You're less likely to get fever with a cold. There are some people who can have flu and not have fever, but in general, people will have fever. They will feel much, much sicker.
Okay. And what should you do if you do get this? Chicken soup, or you do need to go to the hospital.
Chicken soup's not bad. And it's important to let your doctor know if you do have flu-like symptoms, because there's treatment, and it is indicated in certain people to cut down on the chance of complications. And it's important then to be treated very early from the start of symptoms, usually within 2 days, to have the most efficacy from the treatment.
Okay, so get vaccinated before you have issues. Practice good hygiene, washing the hands.
Cover your cough.
Okay.
Stay home if you're sick.
Okay.
Don't want to be exposing other people to your germs, and stay away from people who are sick.
And they say now coughing into the sleeve instead of the hand.
Into the sleeve of the hand. But
right,
if you wash your hands afterwards,
okay,
or use tissues, then that also is helpful.
And what about things like Tamiflu? Do you recommend those?
Well, Tamiflu is one of the drugs to treat influenza.
Okay.
So, again, if you think you have the flu, you should talk to your doctor. Tamiflu is indicated in the very young children, pregnant women, people over 65, and people with certain chronic medical conditions. So they should talk to their doctor.
Okay.
But again, you should be treated with that within the first 2 days to really have benefit. So don't wait.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. A lot of helpful information there, Dr. Dembry. I appreciate you coming in. And of course, you can always go to WTNH.com, click on the Good Morning Connecticut Weekend section, and we'll have all that information for you right there.